Good morning. This meeting is now being recorded. We're going to start in about 4 minutes, but we want you to know that we want to stay connected with you today. Therefore, please visit the chat. I know that many of you know where the chat is. It's the little bubble at the top with the lines. Go ahead and put a message into the chat. Let everybody know who you are. Begin to connect and network. Give them all of the positive information that you want them to have in reference to being able to connect with you later. We do look forward to having a great day. So please take this opportunity to learn how to communicate with each other. Also, we do have the reaction button there where you will be able to, it's at the top, it's got the little hand up like that. You're able to click on that and you're able to raise your hand, ask questions. We're looking forward to hearing from you today. This is community exchange, and that's exactly what it is. It's a great exchange of information from us to you. We want you to capture everything that we have for you today. So please connect with the chat. Tim Thompson is the chat moderator. He will ensure that your questions are heard, whether they are verbal or whether they are in the chat. So please, we will start in about 4 minutes. So go ahead and make the connection with those around you. Thank you. Good morning, Colleen. We are preparing to start.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Colleen Robbs, the director of the Equal Business Opportunity Office here at Solid Waste Authority of Palm Beach County. And we welcome you to our Community Exchange Roundtable. This meeting has been planned with you in mind. We have created an opportunity to exchange information. You're going to hear about a $20 million project. We've created opportunities for matchmaking and teaming. You'll hear about opportunities to ask questions and get your answers. We're going to make sure that we're able to provide all the information you need on this project. on the line today and joining us, we've identified firms who fit the scope of work of this project, major prime contractors, as well as certified firms. And we want you to use this opportunity, as Patty mentioned, to network and to team. We'll share information after this event, but we want you to know that we designed this meeting with you in mind to be able to hear information on the project and to network. Next, we'll have Patty Asbury to introduce the participants that will present today.
Thank you, Colleen, and good morning again. So you just met the director of the Equal Business Opportunity Office, Colleen Robbs, and we want you to know that you are at the right place at the right time. We have many more people for you to meet today, key players that are a part of this great dynamic Solid Waste Authority team. Ramona Carey, our chief engineer. Ramona, wave your hand. It's trying to, your mic, you're on mute, but wave your hand. I wanted them to see, want them to see who you are. Kevin Liang, project manager.
Hello, everyone.
He said, hi, everyone. Thank you for that, Kevin. Belinda Ricklin, SCS Engineering. There's Belinda. She's waving in the back. Can you guys see her? You can unmute Belinda if you'd like.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Belinda. Welcome aboard. Thank you. Then we have Jody Hart, our purchasing director.
Hey, good morning, everybody.
Tricia Armstrong, assistant purchasing manager, but also the project manager for this upcoming project.
Hello, thanks for coming today.
And then we have our great Equal Business Opportunity Office team, Myra Piper, our administrative assistant. There she is. Good morning, Myra. Then Tim Thompson, he's also our chat moderator, but he's one of our contract compliance specialists.
Good morning, all.
Good morning, Tim. And then we have, last but not least, our other contract compliance specialist is Kendrick Jackson.
Good morning.
Good morning. So there you have it. You've got some key people. So you want to make sure to remember those names. Take good notes, because this is going to be a fabulous community exchange today. Now back to Colleen.
Thanks, Hattie. As Hattie mentioned, today's discussion is going to be about the project Class 1 Landfill Sales 1 through 5 closure. And you're going to hear from our engineering department about the project, our EBO office about the SMWBE goal, and our purchasing department about the method of procurement and schedule. So I just want to remind you that although we have Q&A at the end, we encourage you to ask questions throughout this meeting. We want to keep it very informal so that you can really learn about the project and get answers. So with that said, we'll go to the next slide. And I want you to know that our executive director, Mr. Dan Pelowitz, has created an environment and a culture that embraces the EBO's mission, which is to ensure that all segments of the business population, including small, local, minority, and women-owned businesses, have a fair chance to participate in our contracting. And so, to not delay, we're going to hand it over to Ramona Carey, our chief engineer, to kick off the program and talk about the project. And accompanying him will be Kevin, the project manager for this project.
Ramona.
Can you hear me now?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, thank you. I just want to welcome everyone. This project is class one.
You're muted again.
Is it better? Can you hear me?
Hear you now.
Yes, we can hear you, Ramona.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Hello?
Yes, you're good. We hear you.
We hear you, Ramona. You don't have to go through all that.
Now joining the meeting. You've been muted. To unmute yourself, press *6. This meeting is being recorded. You are no longer muted.
Hello?
We hear you.
Perfect. Thank you. Sorry, it was a technical glitch. Again, welcome everyone. I just want to give you a brief introduction to this project and then turn it over to Kevin Lang, who's going to be the project manager for this project. So this is approximately a 75-acre project, and it's going to be constructed in three phases, like you see there on your screen. The first phase on the west side, it's the blue-collar area. The next phase would be the area shaded in green, and then the last phase would be to the south, which is shaded in orange. The project location is 6330 North Jog Road. It's off of 45th Street and Jog in West Palm Beach. But just to give you some bearings, to the top of the page is Jog Road, and to the left is 45th Street, and the bottom of the page is Turnpike. So basically, you're to your right is north. So this project is a multi-year project. It involves closure. We got the permits in hand from FDEP to move forward on this thing. And Kevin's going to talk about the project scope and what it entails. And then he's going to turn it over to Colleen and Trish Armstrong, who's our project manager in purchasing. And she'll provide you the details on, when this project is going to be out on the street for bid. With that, I turn it over to Kevin. Kevin, it's all yours now.
Thanks, Ramona. I'm Kevin Lang, the project manager for this closure. So as Ramona stated, this is a topography map. So let me show you the areas of focus here. At the top of the page in blue, this is what we envision as being phase one. And the grading around the perimeter here is around 30 feet, and it rises towards the center of the landfill to 167. And this blue region we refer to as the west slope. It's consisting of cells 5, 8, and 9. It's approximately 30 acres. The east slope, highlighted in green, is cells 6, 7, and 10. It's approximately 38 acres. And over here, shaded in red, is partial cells 1 and 4, which is a little over 5 acres. And you can see some arrows pointing out a couple of our stockpiles. So we have stockpiles for about 50% of the project, specifically for protective cover, this south stockpile. In addition, this middle stockpile is going to be used for our grading layer. And if you're a stickler for detail, you may have noticed that cells 5 and 8 are currently at a 3-to-1 slope, whereas over here to the over here for cells 1 through 4, You can see that this is the terrace design of the original closure and the original grading. So that may be something of note for everyone. Moving on, this is an aerial view. Imagine being positioned on 45th Street looking north. So again, as Ramona stated, this road on to your left up here, this would be jog. Along the right here would be turnpike. So we're looking north, and as you can see, we've graded a majority of the west slope already. In these following slides, you can see these are some older photos of the original terraced design. Again, similar position of southwest corner of the landfill looking northeast. This is a slightly newer photograph. Again, you can see that we've begun to grade 3:1. And over here, this is maybe our most recent photograph of the project location, specifically what we imagine as being phase one. You can see that the 3:1 grading, you can see that, you know, we're currently finishing out that west slope. So prior to the closure of this west side, everything will be ready for closure when this project begins. So we imagine this will be the area to start. So the scope and cost estimate, the overall area is 75 acres approximate, plus or minus. The cost, the preliminary estimate, we see that as being around $20 million. And the primary task is split into three categories of work. We have a landfill gas collection system, we have earthwork, and we have geosynthetics. So the landfill gas collection system rehabilitation basically begun with some surface hits and surface monitoring, which yielded unfavorable results. So we performed some studies to identify underperforming gas extraction wells. These extraction wells, we plan on decommissioning and redrilling as needed. The new system is going to include new vertical gas collection wells, lateral piping, header piping, and the new header will connect to the existing headers of the neighboring cells. Now, as far as earthwork and geosynthetics, there's going to be 12 inches of grading layer. You know, obviously, as I previously stated, about 50% of that will be available on site. Then we'll have the geomembrane, geocomposite, 18 inches of protective soil, 6 inches of topsoil, which combined will meet our 2-foot requirement for protective soil. And obviously, everything will need to meet the Florida Administrative Code 62-701. Which will obviously include quality assurance, quality control testing for the liner, screening for soils, et cetera. So what we expect as far as the experience and qualifications required for the three main scope items that I've identified is we envision the successful bidder will have 3 completed landfill closures, a minimum of 10 acres each, all within the last 10 years. So these are the requirements if you're expecting to do the liner, the membrane, the earthwork, the gas system, and the primary subcontractors for these work, they should have this following requirements. Now, obviously, if you are doing, you know, other like gas or hauling, things like that, obviously those requirements would not apply to this. So some of the major line items are identified here, just to give you an idea of the scope. This is a very rough draft provided by SCS engineers. And again, if you have any questions, feel free to ask right now while we have Belinda Ricklin on. She's a very good resource that's available for us today. So this draft, I just put this on here to give you an idea of the scope. You know, if you're a small guy out there providing, you know, piping, or if you're able to provide soil, you know, this just gives you an idea of the scope. For example, there's around $1 million in the landfill gas system alone. Let's just pull out a random line item here, line item 16. You know, 2-inch diameter HDP air supply pipe. You know, we estimate about $100,000 in that alone. So just trying to highlight that the scale of this project is fairly significant. So over $15 million for the final cover system. For example, line 37, 6 inches of topsoil. I mean, that's around $1 million. The installation of the topsoil is $300,000. So this is a tremendous opportunity for everyone. You know, if you're a small business out there, I would definitely reach out and, you know, see what we can do. So with that, I'm going to hand things over to Colleen, our EBO director. Again, feel free to ask any questions at any time through the chat.
Okay. Thanks, Kevin. So I just want to make sure, Tim, if you see anyone who has put a question in the chat or someone who's raised their hand, we want to give you an opportunity to or ask the question, or we'll read the question you've entered, and then we've got a team of people here to answer. So we just give a moment. Tim, do you see anything we need to address at this time?
There's a couple of things that have popped into the chat. First question is, will the presentation be made available? That's from Vince Zanini. That's the first question. Will the presentation be made available?
Yes, we will email it to all of the attendees, as well as post it on the EBO website. And also sometime after the event, we will post this recording.
Great. Question number two is, will there be any need for utility locates?
Kevin, do you want to answer that, or I can answer it?
I believe the answer is yes, but yeah, the answer is yes.
I'll expand on that a little bit. There will be some limited locates. You know, I mean, this is not underground construction. You know, please remember, you know, this is a closure. So anywhere it ties to existing infrastructure, yes, you know, I mean, you would need locates. But this is all like construction on top of a landfill mostly. You know, there will be locations where you would need, you know, basically underground utility locates for tie-ins. You know, that's the extent of the scope here.
I don't have any other questions yet, Colleen.
Okay, thank you, Tim. All right, so the authority's intent is to place a 3% SMWBE subcontracting goal, and the documentation of the prime's commitment to the firm's subcontractors that they will commit to utilize must be provided at the time of bid. And so again, I just want to emphasize that the authority is so interested in identifying and encouraging qualified major primes and subcontractors to bid our work. We are creating opportunities for you to meet with our PMs, our chief engineer, our purchasing staff, the EBO staff, so that you have a clear understanding before we get to the formal part of when the bid is advertised and the pre-bid and all of that. So I just want to let you know that we are so interested in letting you know that we are open for business, and we are interested in meeting new contractors as well as encouraging our existing contractors to bid our work. So with that, we'll move to the next slide that piggybacks on what Kevin has mentioned, which is the potential opportunities for SMWBEs. And that will be on the next slide, Kevin, where we've identified, we call it commercial commercially useful function, that's basically just saying parts of the scope that we've identified that are really good opportunities for our certified SMWBEs. And you'll see the different areas. And you will note that you will find yourself in one of these scopes because that's how we identified you and invited you. So you'll see serving and an estimated dollar amount of $150K, field hauling, $1 million, screening, 800,000 sod material and installation. We want you to install it as well, 1.2 million. Landfill gas piping, Kevin mentioned that. Erosion control, fuel, site services, so, you know, trailers, porta potty, and geotechnical testing. So we have invited several firms that are on and joined us today that do these types of services or provide the product. And so it's important that you take the opportunity to put your information in the chat. We're going to share with everyone who we identified, so that information will be available. We are really making a great effort to provide you with the most information during this opportunity. So although the authority intends to set a 3% goal, when you add up the dollars of the different scopes, you can see that it totals, you know, over $3 million. So there is opportunity. The 3% is a minimum percentage. And so therefore, we encourage our prime bidders who will go after this work to use certified firms to the fullest extent and get the greatest amount of participation.
Colleen,
and so
we do have a couple more
towards
questions.
The 3% SMWBE goal, firms must be certified as a small minority or woman-owned business. That means that they must be also located in Palm Beach County. Now, the Solid Waste Authority doesn't certify firms. However, we accept certifications from State of Florida certifying agencies. From the start, we wanted to remove additional work on small companies. So there's no additional certification that we're going to require you to apply to us, but use the certifications that you already have. You've already gone through the paperwork and been approved. So those agencies that we generally take would be the City of West Palm, Palm Beach County, the School Board of Palm Beach County, and the South Florida Water Management District. And if you have any questions regarding certification, any questions regarding identifying firms, you'll have a slide later with our contact information and we can help you with that. Thank you. And so now you'll hear from Trish Armstrong, who's the Purchasing Services Project Manager, about the schedule.
Hey, Colleen, it's Tim. Can I get a couple questions in there before we move on to Trish?
Sure.
The one question I think that popped up was, is there a need for survey staking and as-built? That came from Scott.
This is Kevin.
Absolutely. Yep. Yeah, go ahead, Kevin.
I believe that since the phasing of the project is critical to the success of the entirety of the project, I believe we're going to be doing as-built surveys as each phase is completed.
Correct. And to add to that, you know, we need to hit certain elevations for grading. So there would definitely be staking plans provided to the surveyor and to the contractor, basically, and they're going to hire, you know, the surveyor on their team. And we definitely need a staking plan. You know, this is a closure project, and typically, you know, we have, you know, a good amount of survey work. You know, as Colleen mentioned before, we're estimating about $150,000 worth of work, primarily staking and as-built and making sure, you know, we get 12 inches below the cap. and 24 inches above, you know, so just to make sure it meets the state's requirement. There are stringent Florida Administrative Code requirements here, and surveying is a key component of this project.
Great, thank you. We can move on. Thank you.
All right, I'm Trish Armstrong. I am the Assistant Purchasing Manager here at the Authority. And as Hattie mentioned, I am the Purchasing Project Manager for this. Again, thanks for joining us today. Just a quick timeline here. We are hoping to advertise this bid late fall. Look for that in a couple of months. The targeted construction date is late 2021. And then construction completion is expected by the summer of 2023. The solicitation method for this project will be invitation to bid. When those bid documents are available, they'll be advertised on the Palm Beach Post, El Latino newspaper, on the Solid Waste Authority's webpage, and on Channel 20. Bid documents will be available via the NEGO Metrics platform. It's an e-procurement platform. If you have not registered for at NEGO Metrics, please do. Details are provided there on that web link. You can also find information on registering for NEGO Metrics on the Solid Waste Authority's bid webpage. Once we are ready and with the solicitation, a pre-bid meeting and a site visit will be held. Those details will be provided in the bid documents. If you have any questions about the procurement process, please reach me via email at parmstrong@swa.org. Thank you.
Thank you, Trish. So now what we're going to do is take a minute for open questions. Hope you've taken really good notes because there's some important information that's been shared today. So we freely want you to have the opportunity to ask your questions. So if you have a question, you're able to address that to the SWA staff, the key SWA staff at this time. If there's a question that has not been answered that is in the chat, please go ahead and let us know at this time. I can't believe it. No questions?
Hattie, this is Tim. Are mics going to be open for this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, folks, you heard that. Mics are open.
Open your mic. You have an opportunity to speak. This is great. Okay. So, did we see more in the chat, or did we cover all of the chat questions?
Yes, we covered chat questions. What's happening now is folks are actually entering, you know, their contact information, who they are, what their capabilities are, which is a good thing because that's a connection we really wanted to make. But again, if you have questions, mic's open, and now's the time to. You have the chief engineer and the project manager on the line. Now's the time to ask that question.
Thank you, Tim. So, but in the meantime, what we're going to do is move ahead, Kevin. And we can come back if you have a question, but right now we're going to allow you to meet the purchasing director, who is Jody Hart.
Hello, good morning. Thank you so much, Hattie. My name is Jody Hart. I'm the director of purchasing over here at the Authority. And, you know, this is a very unique opportunity that's being presented to you. We are committed at the Authority to work with you and the entire vendor community. We want a large and diverse pool of vendors in all of the disciplines. So please use this opportunity to make sure that if you feel that you're a candidate for the prime, that you're using this opportunity to make relationships with various subcontractors that are available to you. And if you feel that you have the ability to meet some of these areas that you're connecting not only with the people who are primes, but there may be some people that you are working with or have a network with that may not be on the call. And please reach out to them. Networking is a key to all of our growth and success. So please reach out to each other and create relationships that will benefit this and future projects. So I'll pass that over to you, Colleen.
Okay, thanks, Jody. Jody's right. We are definitely interested in increasing the number of qualified contractors that are participating in our bids. And we want to ensure that we're able to help you identify certified firms. As Jody mentioned, you probably have vetted a subcontractor directory already. Please encourage your subs to register as a vendor with us. You'll get more information on that. And as so that we are able to continue to connect with you. This has been an awesome opportunity today. It doesn't end here. We want to continue to exchange information with you, and we want to know who you are and the type of services and products that you can provide to us. And that's why we focused on this project today, and we appreciate you joining us today. So with that, we're going to hand it to Hattie, and she's going to close us out.
Hey, Hattie, I'm sorry to interrupt. You know, I just have a quick question. This is Romana. Are we going to provide the contact information for all the attendees who participated today? So that way, you know, if they have to reach out to their subs or primes, they can do that?
Yes, absolutely we are. Thank you.
Yeah. One more question, if you don't mind, from Dan Griffin wants to know, are we going to be able to lay sod both? Are we going to be able to lay sod up and down and not left or right?
That's means and methods. You know, I mean, I'm not going to say one way or the other. You know, I mean, it's left to the contractor and the specifications, you know. So that's like, you know, minutia. We're not going to discuss that today. I'm sorry, you know. So.
Okay, great. That's all I have. Thank you.
So, Ramana, could you share with the contractors that are on the line just our thought process of how the contract would be managed, you know, just general information on, you know, like you were saying, we may leave the awarded contractor to implementing how it's to be done. Maybe you can share a little information on that with those that are on the line.
Absolutely. Like Kevin mentioned and Trish mentioned, you know, this is a multi-year project, you know, so the tentative start date is sometime this fall. You know, there are multiple phases of this project. And Kevin showed you the phasing plan. You know, Kevin or Trish or Hattie, you know, if you can go back to the phasing plan, please, you know, the first couple of slides. We envision the project to start on the west side. And the reason being, you know, I mean, they're up to final grades on the disposal. Yeah, that's a good one. Which is basically, you know, the blue area there, the top of the page, you know, that's going to be roughly phase one. You know, phase one has two subcomponents, you know, 1A and 1B. 1A is basically installation of the gas system and modifications there within that area. And everything that's shown within that blue area is up to final elevations. We're not doing active disposal of ash. So that would be the first phase. And if you were in the liner business, which this project has very stringent qualification requirements are, most of the work is going to be done in the dry season, you know, which is basically from, you know, December on until about June. And so we're going to give you broad guidance on phasing plans. But again, you know, we're not going to dictate means and methods and how you accomplish this thing. And if you have a better way of, like, completing this project, you know, our end goal here at the authority and our consultant SCS engineers is to have this project wrapped up by end of spring 2023. And that's a schedule that Trish presented. So given that time frame, you know, you got about 22 months, roughly 20 months. And within that time frame, you know, we believe, you know, this could be done. And we will give you broad guidance, like I said, you know, phase 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, and 3. And the reason why, you know, we want the second phase to start next year is that area is not up to final elevations right now. We're doing active landfilling within that area. Ash is being disposed off there. And it's going to take a little over a year for that area shaded in green to get to final elevation. And it has the same scope as on the west side, which is basically the gas system rehab. And then you come back and do the final cap system there. And then the last phase, that little piece to the south, you know, area shaded in orange or green, you know, how it looks on your screen. That's the last phase because we have a big stockpile sitting over there. And we think, you know, they're probably, you know, that area has settled a little bit. So we're going to reopen that and deposit some ash in there, bring it up to final grades. And that's going to be the last piece of this puzzle. And basically, you know, 22-month project. And given that guidance, you know, the contractors can come up with, you know, a bunch of creative ways. You know, I mean, I think Dan Griffin saw it, asked the question, you know, so how would I install it? We leave it to you, you know what I mean? So you're in the business, you know, like how to do this thing. You know, we don't install sod, you know, we don't do liner, you know, so we manage projects and our consultant design projects. We give you specifications on how to go about, you know, so if you have other ways of getting this accomplished, you know, that's something, you know, you would bring about after the contract during the construction phase. You can send RFIs and, you know, work with the engineer and our engineering project manager, Kevin. And so we'll take a look at it and approve, you know, everything, you know, on its own merit.
Great. Thank you, Ramana. I didn't know if you wanted to ask Belinda to weigh in to provide any information that may be valuable to the contractors that have joined us today. Belinda?
Absolutely. Belinda? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't have much more to add. Ramana explained it very well, and Kevin as well. You know, this project is going to be done in phases, and, you know, you can see there by the coloring. So that's why it's a, you know, 2-year process to get to that closure and allow the authority to, you know, build that east side on the, you know, the side slope. So I do want to mention, it was kind of briefly touched upon, that previously, the closure to the south, shown to the left on your screen, was done with terraces, and we were able to permit them to have 3-to-1 side slopes, so there is a transition there, and it will all be 3-to-1 side slopes on the east and west side with a top surface of about 2-3%. So, you know, even though this topo survey doesn't show that at this point, that is the intention, you know, with the side slopes. So... besides that, I don't have anything else to add unless somebody has questions.
Okay, Tim, if you could check the chat or if anyone has their hand raised, we'll answer those questions or we will move forward.
No questions.
Handing it to Hattie.
Good.
No questions. Okay, great. So what we want you to know today is that there are some great benefits and staying connected with SWA. You've heard some great information today. Now the question is, what will you do with what you've heard? How will you begin to prepare yourself so that when it's ready, set to go, that you are first in line? So one of the benefits of registering with SWA as a vendor is that you have firsthand information. You get it first. You get contract opportunities when they're available. You'll learn about all of our free trainings, and you'll know about networking events such as this and more. So what we want you to do is to register today, and Tim will put this in the chat. Register today online at swa.org/vendor. That's swa.org/vendor. If you are not a registered vendor with SWA, do it today. So when these great opportunities are presented, You're the first on the list to get the notification. You definitely want to do that. Now, we want you to stay connected. Connection is a powerful thing. You know why? One of the people that I love and admire so much is Helen Keller, because for a blind woman, she had more vision than anybody I knew. She says, alone, we can do little, but together, we can do much. We want to help you succeed. Therefore, we want to continue to stay connected because SWA really is a great place to be. What will you do with the information that you've learned here today? Where will you start? Where will you begin? We're saying to you right now, let's stay connected. For more information on bid opportunities, please contact us. At the EBO office, you see the number on the screen. Tim will also put that in the chat. The purchasing services, you heard from Jody and you heard from Trish. Contact them today at 640-4000 extension 4527. We say to you, thank you. And just remember that the Solid Waste Authority of Palm Beach County is the place to be. Thank you.
Thank you, Hattie. And thanks everyone for participating. And I just look forward to you attending other events here before the bids are open and team up with the primes and subs, you know, as appropriate. And we need more bids on this thing. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us today.
Take this opportunity to put more information in the chat. It will be up for a while so that as people put it in, you're able to retrieve it. Tim has just put in great information about how to contact Ramana, Kevin, Colleen, Jody, and Trish. So make sure that you get the information from the chat and it will be open for you to continue to input your information. Back to you, Colleen.
Thank you again for joining us today. Feel free to share this information. We're gonna email it to everybody who attended an RSVP. We're gonna post it on our website. We do want to do business with you. If you need assistance with creating your credentials to sign in for Negometrics, contact purchasing. If you need help with identifying certified vendors and getting registered as a vendor, please contact the EBO office at 561-640-4000 extension 4532. Thanks. And make it a great day.
Thanks, Colleen.
Bye.
Thank you.
Sam. Get it? All right. Very good. Yeah, right? Yeah, they, I think that Anna Lee,